Did you know the greatest depth in the Pacific Ocean is around 11 kilometers? Well, get this. Uranus's moon Ariel may once have had oceans 170 kilometers deep. Ariel itself is the 14th largest moon in the solar system and the second closest major moon to Uranus. It's only 1,159 kilometers across, but its surface features fascinate astronomers, with fractures, ridges, and craters next to very smooth features that could be hints of ice volcanoes. The only close-up images we have of Ariel were taken by Voyager 2 as it flew by in January of 1986. Like many moons in the solar system, Ariel orbits its planet in an elliptical path, meaning it gets closer and further from Uranus as it orbits. This changing distance creates tidal forces and means the shape of the moon is distorted in different ways at different times in its orbit. Researchers were interested to look at the features they see on the surface of Ariel and try to figure out how much distortion of the moon would have been needed in the past to create the features. From there, they could determine what the orbital path of Ariel could have been to create the required tidal stresses. What they discovered was that Ariel's orbit around Uranus could have been up to 40 times more eccentric in the past than it currently is to produce the observed surface features. There are two possible scenarios. Either Ariel had a very thin layer of ice on a very large ocean, meaning it needed less eccentricity and less stress to crack the ice, or it had thick ice on a smaller ocean, in which case the much more eccentric orbit would be needed to create the stresses in the moon that lead to the observed surface features. This same group of researchers looked at Uranus's moon Miranda last year, and it seems like both may have been ocean worlds in the past. To date, we've only observed the southern hemispheres of the two moons, so at some point we need to go back to get a good look at them with a spacecraft so we can unravel their histories in more detail. It's easy to look at all the amazing research being done on galaxies and the early universe and other incredibly large scales and think that we've explored our own solar system in great detail. But the reality is we've barely even scratched the surface of our own backyard, and we certainly have a lot more to discover and learn. This cool research was published in the journal Icarus. That's today's video. Don't forget to drop a like. I'll catch you in the next one.